For most of the conditional formatting options, the conditional formatting is based on the cells that you've highlighted. So if I highlighted those cells, Excel looks at each cell, what's in it, and then depending what's in it, will make a decision on what the formatting should be. It might look at this and then compare it to something elsewhere, but it's always looking at that cell. There is another option though where you can set it up that these cells will change format not depending on themselves but on another cell. So for example, here you'll see I've got ones, and what I want to happen is, depending if there's a one in here, I actually want this cell or this row to highlight. So the way to do that, we can highlight a number of cells, so perhaps I can highlight the whole lot. If I go to conditional formatting, all these options here work on what you've highlighted. So in order to do what we want to do here, we need to go the long route. We're going to say new rule. And you'll see right at the bottom, there's one that says use a formula to determine which cell to format. So what it's now doing is it's saying, okay, give a formula of some sort that will tell how we handle these cells. Now what's very important to realize is when you highlight an area like this, whatever you type in here is actually going to just cover the cell that's active. So when we set it up, we need to make sure that whatever happens here refers to that cell there. So in this case, what I'm going to say is that cell there, please go check if this cell over here is equals to a 1. So you'll see we've done that. You have to be a bit careful though, because notice that by default Excel puts the dollar signs on. So what this is now saying is that this cell must look there and see if it's a 1. But because this logic is going to be applied everywhere, for example, this cell over here, because of the dollar signs, is also going to look over there. That's not what we want. That cell should follow and look at that cell there. So we need to make sure that the dollar signs are representative. And in this case, what I'm going to say is it must always look in column A, but I'm going to remove the dollar signs from the 12 so that as it goes down, it keeps looking at the relevant row. This is normal. We go set a format and maybe let's make it yellow, for example. And when I say OK, you'll notice that these cells now are being driven not by what's in them, but rather about what's here. So if I needed this highlighted, I could put a 1 here, and you'll see that changes yellow. And if I remove that one, this one disappears. So you have the ability to look at other cells, but you must just keep in mind that when you highlight it, whatever you do is happening to that active cell, wherever it is. So if you go backwards and the active cell is here, you must build the formula as if you're referring only to that cell, and then think about the dollar signs and how it'll affect where it goes and looks. In this example, we want to have a different type of shading so that when London, that gets shaded, and the moment it changes to New York, it automatically gets shaded. So it should look something like the solution, like that. And it should be set up automatically so that if I change this to London, you'll see the shading changes. The solution for this example, so first thing we can do is we can highlight it. And what we know is we need to set up some sort of a formula so that this cell looks above itself, and if it's not the same thing, that entire row must be highlighted. So for example, it should do nothing here. When it gets here, it should realize that there's a different word above it, and therefore it needs to shade that one. So we've highlighted it. We're going to go to a new rule. We're going to use a formula. Now what we're going to do here is we actually are going to refer to ourselves. We're going to say, when you're in the cell, look at this cell, and is it not equal to that cell there? If we leave it like that though, all these cells, even ones down here, are going to just compare those two. So we need to fix the dollar signs. And keep in mind that if I go to the right, if I put no dollar signs on, then it'll compare these. So I always want it to look in column A, but the rows must change. So I'm going to get rid of the dollar signs there. Get rid of the dollar signs there. And let's give it a format. So we'll maybe use a lighter shading. Let's see if that works. So OK. And what you can see it's done is this cell now checks there, sees it's different, and shades it. This cell here compares that cell to this cell. So this entire row now always looks to column A, but as it goes down, it looks down. And this means that if, for example, this actually was New York, when I type New York and I click Enter, the shading changes, and it's a little bit easier to see where things change.